12th overall pick in the draft. It comes as somewhat of a surprise because last week head coach Bill O'Brien said Watson was way ahead of any rookie quarterback he's been around. We're joined by the number 2 pick in the 1998 draft, Ryan Leaf. Welcome back.
Welcome, and you just got back from Alabama where you spoke to the team and to Jalen Hurts.
Yeah, I got an opportunity to spend my time in Tuscaloosa this weekend and see the team, talk to Coach Saban, see what they're up to. Kind of gave him a talk about my experiences in college. Redshirting, I think, was a big thing. There's a lot of entitlement that comes with it, especially being the number one ranked football team in the country perennially. So it was very enlightening for me to see the work ethic and the coaches that put that program into place. It's pretty impressive.
Well, you had some struggles as a rookie quarterback, and last season we saw Dak play really great. So how difficult is it for a rookie quarterback to succeed in the NFL?
It's difficult. It also depends on where you're at. I think that we've had this discussion before. If Dak Prescott is in Cleveland last year, he's not Dak Prescott.
Right.
So you're behind that huge offensive line. You have a great defense in Houston to allow a young quarterback to develop. I think that starting Tom Savage for the first game is fine. The preseason, though they get reps, is meaningless. I'm a Hall of Famer when it comes to the preseason. Make my bust right now. So it's not that important. What they've seen in practice and what they're doing on a daily basis, I think the fact that Hopkins came out and put his support behind Savage means a lot. You really don't know what you're going to get until that first week of the season. You really don't, because I was very confident walking into week one, and defenses are much different when the season starts than they are in the preseason.
Did you start for the Chargers in the preseason games?
I did. I started from game one.
And you would play, what, like a half maybe of each of the first three?
My first start was against the San Francisco 49ers and Steve Young in my first game. And I went 14 for 20 for about 160 yards and a touchdown, and it was...
And you thought this is easy.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, I can do this. I can beat Steve Young. And we're going to get rolling here.
Yeah. And then you progress second, third starts just as good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Started, played really well all through the preseason. Got the support of my teammates. We walked out and played the Buffalo Bills in week one at home. We won. I struggled. I threw 4 interceptions, 2 of them which got called back on penalties. So really 4 I threw. And I think that had something to do with the confidence I took into the weeks that I'm like, wow, I was prepared. And they knew what was coming. They knew what I was doing. I have to get better, or this is going to be a long, long ride.
Mm. And what changed in the real game? What was different?
Well, I think they were prepared for what we were doing offensively, and the speed. I mean, you can just tell that, you know, the guys in the preseason, they're working on technique and they're trying to get better because they knew the real thing. The real bullets are coming in week one, and it's just not the same. I used to be able to get outside that pocket and run away from the 300-pound defensive lineman, and now they are pulling me down from behind, and that was a significant change for me.
For me, I've always felt, especially for a quarterback, it's not when you get drafted, it's where you get drafted to. And Deshaun Watson went to the perfect team because, as you mentioned, Ryan, they have a stellar defense. They get J.J. Watt back on a defense that was very, very good last year with Clowney, with Merciless, and they still have Cushion. So they have a very talented defense. Offensively, Skip, now they did lose full of the fifth. He broke his collarbone. They're expecting him to come back.
Loss.
Yeah, they expect him to come back because he's their deep threat guy. Mm-hmm. But they still have Braxton Miller. They still have DeAndre Hopkins. They can run the football with Blue and Miller. Mm-hmm. So they're a very talented football team. And right now, Skip, when you look at it, and I felt this is why I don't know what you think about this, Ryan. I feel if the two guys are close, you start Watson. But if it's not close, you have nothing to lose by starting Savage, because you can always come to Deshaun Watson. You don't want to start a rookie and then have him not play well and then bench him and then go to Savage, because you really mess with his confidence. Make sure that, because this team is, they have playoff and championship aspirations. It's not just good enough for them to be 8-8 and, oh, we had a good season and we're growing. That's not what they want to do, because they're built to win now. So, Skip, all things being equal, if it's close, I'm going to Deshaun Watson. But if Savage is ahead of him, I'm going to start Savage. And if Savage starts to falter, or we're not winning the way I think we should, because I'm going to go to Deshaun Watson. But it's going to be hard if they're winning, even if it's ugly, to pull Savage and put Watson in. So you got time. Don't rush it out there, Skip, because you don't want to mess this man's confidence up.
I told you before the draft, and I'm going to say it again, I believe in Deshaun Watson's intangibles. I don't think any of this will bother him. I believe in it so strongly that I believe he is another Dak Prescott in intangibles, which is you can't teach it, you can't coach it, you're born with it. Mm-hmm. You can handle it or you can't handle it. And in this case, we saw Deshaun against Alabama in two national championship games rise and shine and play at the highest level against the best defense in college football on the biggest stage in college football. He can do this, but you have to give him a chance to figure it out in the preseason, not to get a false read on what it's like, just to get some reps, start to feel it, because Dak Prescott was lucky last year. He got a bunch of preseason reps. Romo went down on, I believe it was the third play of the dress rehearsal game. And all of a sudden, they're at Seattle. Seattle was flying that night. They were going to show this kid what it's all about. And I think they were playing at a little higher level than you usually get in most preseason games. And Dak stood in against some max blitzes and took shots in the jaw and completed the pass to his hot receiver. And he showed me some body language and some poise that you just don't see kids have thrown into that kind of a fire up in Seattle against that defense.
Correct.
So in this case, I'm also going to defend Dak because, listen, I get it. The line is really good and Zeke was really good and blah, blah, blah. I get all that. But it's still really hard knowing that Tony Romo is coming back pretty soon. Sooner than later, he's trying to get back and get his job back. It's the Dallas Cowboy quarterback, which is, to me, it's as hot a seat as there is in pro football, and you know a little bit about that.
Yeah.
And the pressure on him just mounted from week to week as Romo got healthier and the schedule kept getting tougher. And it was one game after another in which he had to go 80 yards in 12 plays to come back on the Redskins in week two in Washington. And he did. They came back and won 27-23. It's hard, man, to do it under pressure in that seat. That's a hot seat. It, not that the Chargers seat wasn't hot because you were the second pick in the draft and a lot of people thought you should have been the first over Peyton. So you had extreme pressure. And as you pointed out to us, you had no media market pressure in Pullman, Washington to get you ready for what, not that San Diego is a metropolis, but it's yeah. you are getting
pro
a
football.
Lot. It's pro football and you are going to get criticized in your face in San Diego by local and national reporters. So it's, again, Dak Prescott was amazing to me, and I believe Deshaun's built, made of the same sort of born winner kind of stuff that will allow you to take those bullets and keep bouncing back, not crumble under. That's just my view of the two of them.
And I believe that to be the case, too. I think that when you say that, it's not hyperbole where in Cleveland, he wouldn't have been the same Dak Prescott. It would have been different. He wouldn't have won as many football games because collectively it is a team sport.
Sure.
The quarterback gets a lot of the attention.
I don't think he would have crumbled in Cleveland. I think he would have been okay.
Yeah.
They would have been okay. They might have won three or four games.
Yeah, the maturity and the way he was brought up and the adversity he had gone through with the loss of his mother and things like that, or the loss of his mother like that, that brought him to the man he is right now. And he is. The Dallas Cowboys quarterback is the forefront of everything. I don't care if Tom Brady, Aaron Rodgers, you wear that star on your helmet, you are America's team for everybody to see, and you have to perform well or you're going to get criticized more than anybody.
But see, the thing is, what Dak was a what, third or fourth round pick?
Fourth. Yeah.
They traded up 13 spots to take Deshaun Watson. So he's facing different pressure to begin with to start. Because it's like, well, he's a fourth round pick, and that's what everybody keeps saying. Well, he's a fourth round pick. Nobody saw this coming. Well, you move up 13 spot, everybody's supposed to see this coming. So I wouldn't, if it's close, if it's a neck and neck, you know, coin flip, I'm going with Deshaun Watson. But if it's not that close.
Okay, but how do you know it's neck and neck? I mean, like, Deshaun is a big stage player, and you know you've seen kids before who, once the lights come on, they're just a little better than they are even in practice.
Yes. I think Coach O'Brien, he will know. He will see enough in practice. He'll see enough in – and it's not so much that when Deshaun goes in, because he's going to be playing against guys that's not going to be started, especially he'll probably – Savage will probably play the first quarter, and then Deshaun will probably take the second and third quarter, then they go from there. So he's not going to be playing against maybe some guys that's going to be playing on Sunday.
Yeah.
But Coach O'Brien has been around enough quarterbacks, and he's seen enough. He'll know if his guy's ready.
You know, you brought up DeAndre Hopkins. It surprised me that he said, and I quote, "I put my stamp on Savage." And he said, I know because I've been around more quarterbacks my first 4 years than anybody in NFL history. And it's a long list of mediocrity. You know,
but guess what, Skip? Guess who one of them quarterbacks been in them 4 years? Tom Savage.
Okay.
Yeah, so.
So I don't know if DeAndre was trying to take pressure off Deshaun. Like, I don't know. It sort of rubbed me the wrong way because I'm a fan of Deshaun, and I hoped his veteran teammates would start to be won over, but they're riding with the guy they've been with for 3 years, even though he hasn't been starting for 3 years.
This may be an opportunity to build his confidence. You're going to play second and third quarter. Mm-hmm. You're going to get a lot more reps. You're going to go against maybe not the most talented on the other side, and might build his confidence on what he's capable of doing. And Coach O'Brien has a plan. You know, he's taken with a lot less two division titles.
But you said it earlier, it's a little different speed once you get to the regular season.
Yeah.
Was it a mistake for Josh Rosen?